Galonians, good evening, good afternoon, and good morning, depending upon which part of the world you are. I extend special Eid Mubarak to you. Today is a special day of peace, special day of unity, happiness, love, and service to Allah. Many of us have spent the past 29 to 30 days fasting and asking for God's mercy to atone our sins. Today, many are happy, but there are many others who may not know where the next meal will be coming from. There are so many of our youth, men and women, that are troubled today. Troubled due to the failures of leadership over the past 3 or 4 decades. I know the powers that we have today are also challenged. Challenged in so many ways because they inherited a government that is troubled. They inherited a government that has a lot of problems to address. But they too are a product of the same trouble from which the kids of today emanated from. Failures of the past is a reflection of what we see happening in the country today. So it is time for the leadership of this country to be magnanimous in victory and try to reconcile the nation and bring us all back together. In this day of Eid, one of the key highlights that I took from the sermon that was delivered at the mosque is that leadership is entrusted into individuals within society. And when you're entrusted with power, you're expected to work with sincerity in the interest of the people. And if you fail them, if you are insincere, then the doors of heaven will be shut to you. So these guys that have led us over the past decades, some of them are deceased, some of them are still alive, like an Esbai Koroma. They have a lot of atonement to do. They have a lot to do to atone to their sins. They've looted our economy over the past 10 years. They need to find a way to pay back some of those debts. I know some of them do not even believe in the existence of heaven and hell. So they may not even take, such message is serious. But it's true. You were entrusted with the leadership of the nation and you betrayed that trust. It is high time for you to pay back. Now, for those that are in power now, I know some of you are troubled because you emanated from violence. You lived your youthful life in violence. You took over a political party in violence. You imposed yourself in the leadership of Sierra Leone in violence. But this violence must stop. This violence must stop. We should all preach peace. We should all walk on the path of peace. We should all try to reconcile with one another. This division that was sown by leaders of yesteryears between APC and SLPP, dividing the nation by tribes and by region, must end. So, President Madabio, you have the greatest opportunity for you to reconcile us. But reconciliation does not mean that you should negate on your responsibility to hold those responsible that have looted our economy over the past 10 or 11 years. They need to pay back. The issue about commission of inquiry must go on. The anti-corruption must go on. But it must be done within the ambit of the law. You cannot claim to be enforcing the law and breaching it in the process. You have micromanaged the outcome of the court to get rid of some APC members of parliament. There was enough evidence to get them out of parliament following the tenet of the law without you resorting to getting the judiciary to impose SLPP in place of them without going through elections. The laws are clear. I know the judges are part of the problem. They too must search their soul and take recognition of the role that they play in bringing discord, in creating anarchy, in creating disunity within the nation. So let us all walk towards the interest of the Republic of Sierra Leone. It is the only country God has given us as a gift, and we must embrace it and serve it as expected of God, as expected of us. This I ask you in the name of Allah. This is Jisna Fodimanusun. Eid Mubarak. Thank you.